In part 9 of our lesson on applications of vectors, you will learn how to solve problems involving current on a river. In this example, a fisherman wants to cross a river that is 264 feet wide in a motorboat that travels 9 miles per hour. The river runs due south at 4 miles per hour. The ending point on the other side of the river must be directly across from the starting point. So here's the river flowing south. These are the river banks. The starting point is on one side of the river, and the dotted line represents the path that the fisherman wants to travel so that he ends up here, directly across from his starting point. So the dotted line that is his path is going to be perpendicular to the riverbank. We have to make a diagram here so we can start marking the information that we know. We know that the riverbanks are 264 feet apart from each other. So we know this distance, 264 feet. Now the motorboat travels 9 miles per hour, but much like we saw with the airplane in the wind, if the fisherman were to point the boat along the dotted line path, the river would push him downstream and he would end up traveling a path where he ended up farther south down the opposite side of the riverbank than he wants to be. So considering that the fisherman is right here at the starting point, the river is pushing on his boat at 4 miles an hour to the south. We know that he cannot point the boat directly across the river, so to counteract that the river is pushing against him at 4 miles an hour, he's going to need to take the boat and turn it upstream and point it this way. So the fisherman will point the boat upstream, and he is traveling at 9 miles per hour, so that the river can push him downstream at 4 miles an hour. And he will end up at the ending point that he desires. We can see that our parallelogram is just about made. We can dot in this last side here. And the dotted line here is the resulting path that we want. So this is the resultant. We are being asked, what is the speed of the boat relative to the riverbanks? So we want to know what is the speed associated with this dotted line right here. Maybe we will call this X. Analyzing our diagram, we see that X and 4 and 9 make a right triangle in terms of miles per hour. And in this part of the question, it's asking us about the speed. It's not asking us about distance, so we're not using this 264 feet. It's asking us about speed. So the 9 miles an hour is a speed, the 4 miles per hour is a speed, and then X will then be a speed. Because we have a right triangle here, we can actually use the Pythagorean theorem. X is one of the legs. So we know then that X is going to be the square root of the hypotenuse squared, 9 squared, minus the other leg squared, 4 squared. This is equal to the square root of 81 minus 16, which is radical 65. And if we punch that into our calculator, square root 65, and round to the tenths place, we find out that the boat is traveling 8.1 miles per hour. So we can answer the question here by saying the speed of the boat is 8.1 miles per hour. Next, we are being asked, how long will it take to cross the river? So, how long, we know, means we have to find the time. And we know the equation that involves distance, rate, and time is distance is equal to rate times time. Now, if we solve that for t, then we would get d divided by r is equal to t. So if we want to find the time to cross the river, we know we want to put the distance that the river is, 264 feet, divided by the rate, which we just found was 8.1 miles per hour. Now notice that we have a units mismatch here. We have feet in the numerator and we have miles in the denominator, so we can convert. We have 264 feet that we can change into miles by using a conversion factor. 1 mile is 5,280 feet. We put that in our calculators. 264 divided by 5,280. And this works out to be 0.05 miles. So let's get that into our equation. This becomes 0.05 miles divided by 8.1 miles per hour. Now just looking at the units, we see that miles in the numerator will cancel with miles in the denominator, and because hours is in the denominator of the denominator, when we divide, hours will go into the numerator. So the units of our answer will be hours. So let's type this into our calculators. 0.05 divided by 8.1, and we see that we get 0.00617, a whole bunch of decimal places, hours. Now, no one on Earth talks like that. If you asked your friend, how long did it take you to cross the river in the boat, no one would say 0.006 hours. So we will want to convert this. And since it's so tiny, I wouldn't even think it's going to be minutes. It's probably going to be seconds. So since we're going to want to convert this, let's go ahead and store this in a memory location in case we need to get back to it. We'll put it in A. So store A. Now, to convert this, we've got this 0.00617 and so on hours. Our conversion factor, we have to change from hours into seconds, we're guessing. So we know that 1 hour, well, there's 60 seconds per minute and 60 minutes per hour. So 60 times 60 is 3,600 seconds. So if we take this number that we have stored times 3,600 seconds per hour and round to the nearest second, we get that it's going to take 22 seconds to cross the river. So let's write our sentence here. It will take 22 seconds to cross the river. Finally, we are asked, at what angle should the boat be pointed to land directly across from the starting point? So let's go back to our picture for just a moment. This question is asking us to find this angle in the diagram. And because we have a right triangle here, we know that we have SOHCAHTOA available to us, and we were given this 4 miles per hour here and the 9 miles per hour here, so we would want to use those in our calculation. The 4 is the opposite leg, the 9 is the hypotenuse, so we will want to use sine function. So let's go back now. Because of that right triangle, we can use SOHCAHTOA. And we had the opposite leg along with the hypotenuse. So we will be solving sine of theta is equal to 4 over 9. We have to take the sine inverse of each side. So the left-hand side is sine inverse of sine theta, and the right-hand side is going to be sine inverse of 4/9. The sine inverse of the sine of theta becomes theta, and on our calculators, we enter sine inverse of 4 divided by 9, and rounding to the tenths place, we find out that theta is 26.4 degrees. We can write our sentence now and say something like, the boat should be pointed at an angle of 26.4 degrees.